Hello, and welcome to this demo video on Cloud for Good's donation history component for Salesforce Customer Communities. My name is Will Nourse, Vice President of Operations at Cloud for Good, and I'll be your host for this walkthrough. Two of the big challenges we often see with clients is with gathering and obtaining updated contact and other information about their donors and other constituents, and in tracking and managing constituent requests for information. In order to help clients overcome these challenges, we built a lightning bolt solution that organizations can drop into their existing customer communities and set up with minimal additional configuration. In this video, we're going to do a quick walkthrough of what the solution looks like. If we log into a community as an existing user, we land on the homepage for the community. In this example, we haven't added any additional content to this page. In the community navigation bar, we can see a link to a donation history page and a member management page. Clicking the link to the donation history takes me to a page where I can see four separate blocks of content: household information, household members, recurring donations, and donation history. Within each of the blocks, the fields to be displayed and their labels can be configured by the organization's Salesforce administrator. The user can see that we are displaying some simple information about them and their giving history. Let's assume that they have moved, however, and want to update their address. In creating this solution, we knew that every organization has different policies about who can update information and that we needed to be careful about how we approach the matter. We went with the most conservative option by allowing the user to request an update, but not actually making the change in the Salesforce database. This allows the fundraising, development, or other team to assess and validate the change before actually updating the organization's data. Let's click the Request Update button and make a request. In our example, we're requesting an address change. So the user would select the address change option from the dropdown and put the information in the request description field. Each of the options is also customizable by the organization's Salesforce administrator to reflect the organization's needs. When the user clicks Save, the request is saved as a task on the appropriate household or opportunity record. The organization could then apply all of the standard Salesforce process automation tools to do things like route the request to a particular user, send a confirmation email to the constituent, or set a time-based workflow to send a reminder to complete the update. The other components operate in a similar fashion, with an addition in the donation history component. Here, when I select a particular donation record, the payments and allocations, if any, are displayed as well. So what we've just seen is the standard page that we've created that an administrator can drop into a community. In addition, each of the individual components can be mixed and matched on any page in the community, allowing the organization to present the information in a way that makes sense for how their community is set up. For example, if I click on the member management link in the navigation bar, I can go to a page that demonstrates this. Here I can see that the page is set up with a different template, and it includes just the household and household member components, as well as the list of cases, which is a standard community component. If desired, the administrator could add a button to make a donation or generate a tax receipt. Additional content can be added anywhere in the template without affecting the data being displayed in the component. Hopefully, this quick overview has shown you the simplicity and power of this solution. You can get it on the AppExchange and install a 30-day trial in your Salesforce customer community to try it out. Thank you, and please let us know if you have any questions.